are watching election numbers come in. We want to start with the governor's race on the Republican side.
Mary Fallin is taking a strong and early lead right now with 6% of the precincts reporting. You can see Mary Fallin has 59% of the votes. Randy Brogdon coming in second with 33% of the votes. Those are the top two candidates on the Republican ticket.
And we want to go out to Mary Fallin's watch party right now with Matt Garcia. Matt.
Yeah, we're here at the Mary Fallin watch party that is in full swing. They're awaiting their candidate who's returning from Washington after having to cast an important vote on funding for the war in Afghanistan. She's in a private jet headed back to Oklahoma City. She'll be expected to arrive here around 9:30, which she will come to Will Rogers Theater and be here for her supporters. And then she's taking on State Senator Randy Brogdon, Oklahoma City businessman Robert Hubbard, as well as Roger Jackson. Some of the supporters are already clapping with regard to some of the early results that are coming through. But we'll be staying on top of this race all night. Let's send it back to Jessica and Paul.
Okay, Matt, thank you. And let's take a look right now at the race for governor on the Democratic side. 6-7% of the precincts reporting right now. And you can see Jari Askins taking the lead with 56% of the votes. Drew Edmondson with 44% of the votes.
And we're getting some numbers in on the lieutenant governor. Todd Lamb is now the Republican candidate. That's according to the Associated Press. You can see there 69% of the votes to John Wright's 16%. He will face Kenneth Corn, who would be the Democrat, and Richard Pruszynski, who is the independent, all three for the lieutenant governor.
And also a race that has been called tonight. Senator Tom Coburn has won the Republican nomination for U.S. Senate. We'll have live election results throughout the evening right here on KOCO.com.